India. Its geographical location gives it a distinct advantage in renewable energy, with specific reference to solar energy. The amount of energy that can be harnessed in India is so huge that India can become an energy superpower in the world. For instance, if half the area of India's smallest state, Sikkim, is covered with solar panels, it will provide us enough energy to take care of the entire country's energy needs. Reducing dependence on carbon fuels has relevance to the society's economic development and the country's energy security. Given this backdrop, after over 3 years of discussion, through the financial support of DST, IIT Madras has taken lead for the creation of the Indian Solar Energy Harvesting Center, ISEHC, an energy consortium that brings all stakeholders of the energy sector together. The intention is to create a knowledge institute that catalyzes the development of energy technologies of relevance to the sustainable future of India and the globe.
The Indian Solar Energy Harnessing Center is a unique center funded by the Department of Science and Technology, which we are in the process of establishing this center here. The nucleation for this center happened because of the individual projects funded by DST during the last 6 years. And DST felt that IIT Madras has the capability of carrying out high-end research. So they have envisaged a consortium where almost about 25 faculty members from various departments contribute to the growth of the center and to meet the set objectives. We are all together because there are four domains in this particular national center. The PV domain, that is split into two parts. One is one deals with one of the major deliverables, that is the creation of a fabrication of silicon based heterojunction solar cells. We also have a domain that deals with solar thermal energy. We have another domain that deals with energy storage, and another domain that deals with solar fuels. Apart from that, we also have research teams working on the material part of solar systems. You know, we have a group of people working on dye-sensitized solar cells and also perovskite-based solar cells.
ISEC, which is headquartered currently at IIT Madras, aims at being a growth partner for a large number of stakeholders. The obvious beneficiaries would be not just the Indian society in the larger sense, but the global south, as far as I can see. And that has to do with the fact that technology customization to suit our requirements would be a big part of our activities. And the reason why this is exciting for an academic campus like IIT Madras is because this set of activities essentially means that students would get access and exposure to various R&D related works and activities and experience at various technology readiness levels, all the way from, let us say, the basic science end of the spectrum to the more technology end of spectrum, where there could be customization, industry interface, and real translation of technology. The way we have strategized this is by having a full spectrum of stakeholders. And by that, what I mean is, on one hand, we will have academic institutions, we have industry, but we will also have interface organizations that are part of our platforms, which enable translation through various innovation pathways and which allow innovation to go from, let us say, a basic TRL level to a higher TRL level. One of the win-win propositions we bring to the table is, number one, an inclusive growth model, which is facilitated by an administrative structure where there is a secretariat, there will be a monitoring committee which includes a few industry partners, external stakeholders, and also a peer from various parts of the world, and certainly observers who could give us insights for road mapping ourselves. And at the same time, we are fiercely equity driven, and by that what I mean is that we would like to have other partners on board so that we create inclusive growth related system.
The mandate of the center is to develop new technologies to harness the solar energy, and this we are doing it in the form of two types of projects. One is the technology work packages and research work packages. And technology work packages develop technologies that can be transferred to industries, for example, like BHEL. And research work packages are focusing on next generation kind of blue sky areas that we're working on. And we have a very multidisciplinary team of faculty from ranging from scientists and engineers that are working on these projects right now, and we are setting up facilities for that. We also hope to work closely with the industry so that other technologies that we are developing will be transferred and adopted as well. Besides this, we are open to collaborations. We are engaging with different agencies within India and in the international arena as well. Those agencies that are working on various solar energy activities. So through these kind of collaborations and partnerships, we hope to continue the center's activities beyond the initial set of projects that we have identified. And we will keep the center sustaining in itself.
So our goal is to have spin-off technologies in the next few years, more of industry participation to use the technology that we're going to develop and take it to industrial production level that would cater to the needs of the nation.
The booming solar energy sector, if implemented in all sincerity, has the potential to wipe out unemployment in India in a mere 6 to 7 years. It is no wonder that the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, has fired all its resources to promote research and implementation of solar-related technologies. ISEHC invites the industry, academic institutions and research students as stakeholders in this endeavor and join hands to making India not just self-sufficient in energy, but an energy superpower in the shortest possible time.